Hey guys, this is Roxanne with Caprica Soapery, and one of the questions that I get asked a lot when I'm packaging my soap is, where do I get my boxes? My boxes are actually not pre-printed. I paint them myself because I'm bananas. This video is going to kind of quickly step through how I do that process. So I use one cup for each of my colors, and I'm just mixing. Right now I'm pouring out 91% rubbing alcohol. That is the base that I like to use for mixing the dyes. You can use water, but this dries much quicker and stops the boxes from getting wrinkly or anything like that. The dye pigments that I use are actually India ink. They're Dr. P.H. Martin's. You can buy them online. I'll put links to where they come from in the comments down below, but I use about one little dropper full per cup for each color, and the four colors that I'm using today are the turquoise, aqua, violet, and magenta. You want to shake them up before you use them. They do tend to settle out. The pigment at the bottom will settle. Sometimes they get a little sticky and they're a little hard to open, but once you get them going, you can play around with the colors. You can mix them together if you want to. I just use them straight. And like I said, I use about one dropper full per little cup. So there's not really a set mixing ratio for these. I know that I'm painting out about, I think it was 15 boxes today. So I just kind of eyeballed where, how much of this I wanted. And then I can always mix up more if I need to. Once you've poured them into the cups, you want to give them a swirl. You can stir them if you want, but this way I don't get more things dirty or stained. If you spill a little bit like I'm about to do right there, don't worry about it. It all kind of blends together when it's on the final boxes anyway. And the colors do tend to kind of mix together as you paint them out on the boxes. So to spread the color, I've tried using sponges and brushes and different things. What I actually like best is this kind of thick, it's like a facial powder cover brush. It's like a big blusher brush. I stole it from one of my makeup kits, and I just dip it in the dye every two or three boxes and just kind of smash the colors all over. I generally like the effect that you get from like the third box on, when it starts to look kind of fireworks starbursty like that. And then you just go through, do each one, add more dye if you need to. Either tap it out or kind of scrape it off on the side of the cup. You don't want the brushes to be super wet. You can see how you kind of get just plain circle smashes when it's wet all the way. Whereas when it's kind of in the middle level of wetness, you get more of that starburst effect, which is what I'm kind of going for here. Now you could just mark up the parts of the box that are visible to the outside, which is kind of that center T area. I found that I ended up getting effects that I didn't really like because they didn't cover the whole box or they weren't as distributed. So I actually paint the whole box, even the parts that are folded inside, but you can do whatever works best for you. It does use a little bit more materials, but I've had these same bottles of India ink for going on probably 6 months now. They're one fluid ounce per container and they're still almost completely full. Like I've probably used, I don't know, maybe a tenth of a bottle. So if you want to paint the whole box, go for it. It won't do you any harm. So here you can see I'm to the bottom of this first blue color. I've painted all my boxes. You'll notice that the boxes do look kind of dark and wet. That will go away as the boxes dry. At the end of this video, I'm going to let a time lapse run kind of once I'm done chatting. And then you can see the rest of the boxes when I step through the other colors, and you can see kind of a time lapse of how the boxes dry, which looks pretty cool. They start out really dark and kind of splotchy like this, and then they fade to a much paler color. So here I'm going through the next color, which is the magenta, and same thing, just kind of splatting it on wherever you want to go. Mix and match, doesn't matter if you overlap, these colors are going to be much lighter once they're dried. You're not going to have that darkness of the wet cardboard. And then it's just rinse repeat for the other colors. Just keep layering them on, fill in the gaps. You can see on this box how it's starting to dry a little bit where it's paler. Those dark blue splotches are gonna go away as the box dries. So I'm gonna zip you on over to a time lapse now as we go through the rest of these colors. And at the end, you'll be able to see them dry. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments. Thank you. Thank you.